Okay, this one's going to be a little bit different video. What I wanted to do, I get asked about the settings all the time. Well, they constantly change. And one thing that I have found with Profit Trailer and using Feeder, that the settings in a sideways market are incredible. I mean, it just goes crazy. But what I struggle with occasionally is buying some coins that end up down 1 or 2% pretty quickly. Just because the trailer can only hits the API like once every 5 minutes to update settings, but the trailer sometimes doesn't catch as quite as early as what I would like. So I'm going to show you my strategy on what I look and then some of the settings and what they mean. So you're looking at my profit trailer right here on my dashboard, and I have it set to my possible buy log. My settings are based off EMA spread. And you can do some research on EMA spread to see what that means, but I'm basically set up to, I believe it's 2% below the EMA spread that I want to buy. So what I like doing is looking at the possible buy logs and finding coins that are triggering and then manually going and looking to buy those. Now on a sideways market, like I said, you'll kill it all day long. But when this market has been very volatile lately and you're seeing Bitcoin drop quite a bit and then up again, I find it's a lot easier doing it this way. And I'm actually increasing the amount of profits that I'm making on each one by quite a bit. So I'm just going to show you in my sales log here where you can see WTC, OMG, you know, some of these that I'm buying here. And yeah, my goal is to get 1% at least on every single thing. And I do that for the most part. But that adds up quick, and I feel that I reach that profitability stage much quicker by doing some of these buys manually in this type of market. Okay, so again, I'm back to my possible buy log, and you can see WTC and ELF are two that it's showing currently that are hitting my trigger. So I'm going to go look at both of those right now. And looking at WTC, let me get into the advanced here. So looking at WTC, you're gonna see my indicators here, my EMA lines, and it got way below. So that's where it was actually triggered, was down here, because that is more than 2% below the actual EMA lines. So that's what triggered the buy. But if you don't do it manually, then I could end up buying up here, and that would have taken away some of my profit. Or in this case, it may have bought up here. So that's why I kind of like to watch these once they do trigger and do a manual buy on it. And in this case, I ended up, I think I showed you, got in at 300. And sold at 303, and then another one got in at 308, they sold at 312. So even though this has been going down, I've still been making money on it just because of the settings that I have in place. So let's pull up and look at a few of the settings. Okay, now I'm on my VPS and I'm taking a look at the settings I currently have in place. And as you can see, my trigger is set at a minus 1.25%. So that would be where I get triggered at, and that is below the EMA lines. So that is a little more aggressive than what the Crypto Crow's settings are. I think his is set at minus 3%. And I know a lot of people that are using that. Yeah, you're making money with it, and that's wonderful. But I believe you're making more money on the DCA side with less buys. And DCA means that you're doubling down with your dollar cost average when it hits a certain percentage down. So if it drops to, it's under 3%, the coin you bought is down 3% already, then it may double up on that. And this current market, I'm not doing that as much. I may do more down the line, but I'm relying less on DCA and more on what I can make and buy and sell quickly. So the 1.25% is what I'm sitting on, and mine is set on a 6% of total stashes. So that's how much I can spend on a coin. It is set on DCA enabled if I have the funds in there. I use this particular account just for my trading bot. So a couple other things you're going to want to look at while you're here. I have my max trailing buy set to 0.15%. So what that means is when it does trigger that trigger the bot to buy, the bot does want to try to buy at a lower percentage, so the best possible price it can get for the coin. So it's going to continue to follow it down and follow it down until it goes back up 0.15%. And at that point, that's when it wants to buy. Now, the bot isn't watching the exchange every single second. It sits there and goes back and check prices. If you're using a, or if you're looking at a very volatile coin, you know that some of these can jump 2% in a 30-second period. So you may trigger a coin, but then end up paying a much higher price. So that's why I like to look at mine a little bit more manually when I have time. In a sideways market, it's not a big deal, but when this volatile market is so volatile, it can be an issue. And so you might look at that. And in this situation, I actually have, or I have been setting my bot to sell only mode when I am watching the market. So then I do my manual buys and then it will sell on its own. But that trailing buy, same thing happens on a sell. So my trailing sell is set to 0.15. And again, it will go and it'll keep going higher and higher. And as the coin gets more profitable, as soon as it drops 0.15%, it triggers the bot to sell. Same situation. Now I have my minimum profit set to 1.5%, which that's when I want it to trigger and try to look at selling it then. I believe in the crow's settings, I believe it's 0.75% is that it's looking. So that way it will do a minimum at, I think, 0.5% is what it will. It won't go below that. I like to get mine a little higher right now, especially with the volatility that's happening. If you have any questions, message me in the comments below, but hopefully this helps you out. If you're just getting into to the profit trailer and the feeder and you want to buy it, I put links in the description below. I've also got a link for the VPS down there and then some of my other videos. Thanks.